what's going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78. Hope you guys are doing well today, by the way. And dang, the 680 is kind of filthy on the inside today. Looks a little bit different, too. Well, that's because it's, you know, as you guys already knew, it's not the T680. It is the Freightliner FLB cab over, going a little bit old school. That's going to be kind of the theme for this week for a little bit, of old school trucking. So hope you guys enjoy that, so be sure to tune in later on the week for some more of it. But so we are down here in Los Angeles, California today, picking up a Wilson grain trailer, going to, just take a look here and see exactly where we're going. There we are. Going down to Ensenada, Mexico. As you can see, I finally got Viva Mexico up and running. Thanks to Bear for kind of helping me out with getting the order set up. Much appreciated. So I still have the RCH map installed as well as the MHA map. I've not had any crashes yet, so we'll just have to keep an eye on that. But it seems like it's running fine. So again, thank you, Bear. Much appreciated. Let's go ahead, get this thing fired up. Sounds pretty cool. I will say that. Let's go ahead, hop in here, and get to work. I do like how it has the GPS up there on the dash. That's pretty helpful. Of course, everything I'm using today, as far as the mods go, will be down in the video description, so be sure to check that out. And I know a couple people asked what I'm using for my headset. It's a Track IR with a Pro Clip. And if you guys want, I will also put my profile. You guys can download that and try that out. I'll put that down in the video description as well. I'll also get to all my NVIDIA Inspector profiles down there, so you guys can download those and mess around with those. Inner gear there, girl. And if you guys noticed on the mod spreadsheet now, the first thing I have on there is all my graphic mods and all that stuff. So be sure to check that out. And what I also have linked on there is the video to the NVIDIA Inspector profile how-to tutorial and all that good stuff. So be sure to check that out. I think I tried to remember offhand. I think it is the 3406 550 horsepower engine that I have in this. Sounds pretty good. But I got a couple other trucks and trailers that are from back in the day that I want to use this week, so I'm pretty excited about that. Kind of freshen it up a little bit. Try to get a couple gameplay videos up this week as well. Not done that for a couple weeks yet. J-brake sounds good. Now hopefully this load hasn't expired by the time we get down there. I think we should be okay. I know we had, I think when I took it, I had like 3 hours, a little over 3 hours. So should be good to go. I know I had to cycle through the economy a couple times because I was having some difficulty finding loads to go down to Mexico. Catching about every red light today, so good times. That is A-okay though. Cool little truck though. I actually seen one of these this morning. I wasn't able to snap a picture of it, but going into work, I past one going the other way. Thought it's kind of cool. Pulling a, what was it pulling? Yeah, a big ol' side curtain. I think it was like a tri-axle side curtain. Like how it's got the shifter down, though. That's pretty cool. Nine UPS here. Before I loaded it in the game today, it said it had updated to 1.1.5.3, and I went to the website just out of curiosity to see what the update was, and I totally forgot about them, but all the website said, or the forum said, was compatibility update. He's like, okay, what's all that about? But it turns out it was just for the Valentine's Day skins. So nothing major there. A little bummed out. I was hoping maybe we're getting closer to the New Mexico beta. Or dreaming here, but DirectX 11 support. Weird picking up a grain trailer 42 print, but meh, we can suspend belief a little bit. Alright, where is our little marker at? There it is, and I'm not seeing. Oh, there it is. Floating. I wonder. I was kind of afraid of that. I was hoping it'd give us the option to choose, because there's like different trailers in this pack, if you will. And I was hoping it'd give us the option to, change out the trailers. But looks like it's not set up like that. But that's okay. We will survive. Quad axle action. It's definitely different being in a cab over. That is for sure. Bada bing, bada boom. All coupled up here. Pretty cool looking combo. Alright, got the screenshot capture for the thumbnail. Let's get out here and do us some trailer trucking down to Mexico. I've not seen a whole lot of the Viva Mexico map other than some screenshots kind of here or there. So I'm excited to get down there and check it out. See what the border looks like. That's okay, car. Just, keep on coming. Crazy ass AI. What do you do? Guess I can go. Thank you. 48,000 pounds, so not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Whoops. That truck's got a few options too, so it's kind of nice. At the CB up there. Like how it sounds when you shift though, that's pretty cool. Be on the lookout. I should know in the next couple days, but tentatively planning a live stream for this Friday. Can't remember if I talked about that any of the last episode, but looking to do a live stream of ATS. Probably start out over on YouTube. Might do it on Twitch. I don't know. But probably around 10 a.m. Eastern to like noon Eastern. Probably just, you know, for a couple hours there, get out and do some trucking with y'all. But follow me over on Twitter for more updates on that, at TheMoose78. Got everything all dialed in for streaming now, so I definitely want to take advantage of that. Pretty much got everything dialed in there. I know I've been kind of messing around with the division, testing out with that as far as live streaming goes on Twitch, and I got that dialed in pretty good, but you know, live streaming something like ATS is a little bit different because, you know, completely different game. There's a lot more movement in this, obviously, you know, driving sim, so want to have the quality as good as I can get it. You guys can really sit down and enjoy it. It's not all blurry and fuzzy. I want to get it to where it pretty much looks just like it does here, but also have a quality upstream where you guys aren't getting kind of lag or anything crazy like that. But yeah, hopefully get into some live streaming here. And I should know, hopefully here in the next couple weeks, if my schedule's going to change any at all. Not sure how that's going to affect the YouTubes, but should know a little bit more here in the next couple weeks. Seeing the blip on the map there, we can't be that close. Because we're going all the way down here. Yeah, it's just some kind of glitch or some kind of bug or something. I don't know, but I'm not going to pay too much attention to it right now. Unless that's maybe the border. We shall find out. shall we shall. I know it's definitely good to get some different mods and stuff in the game, because I'm going to be honest, I've been getting kind of burnt out on ATS here lately, just using the 680 and the W900. It was good that the MHA map came along, but not gonna lie, it's been a little bit of a struggle here lately to sit down and make content for the game. And the rescales definitely helped, but was ready for some more new content. I think the RCH, MHA, and Viva Mexico maps are absolutely going to provide that, especially getting some different trucks in here, kind of here and there. But definitely sitting down and enjoying this today for sure. I think this is maybe part of the RCH map. I'm not sure. Seems like there's more lanes of traffic than there typically are. Oh, easy there, buddy. Don't crash out on me. Can I hop over there? Yes, I can. Frames are starting to come back up. Not sure what happened. It dipped down below, like, it's got like down in the mid 40s there for the frames. Weird. Set the cruise there and get on down the highway. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this has to be part of the RCH map, because I know that was one of the things that I read on kind of what they were doing there, adding more lanes and what the hell. Okay, not sure what's going on there, but got cars driving through walls and everything else. That's interesting. Hey, I'm sitting over here in this lane where I think it's safe. Man, what in the world? I don't know if there's some kind of mod conflict going on, or if this is just kind of a something that needs fixed in the RCH map. I'm going to say it's probably something that needs fixed in the RCH map. I know it's a relatively new mod and everything, so they're probably still just getting some bugs and kinks and whatnot worked out. I know they've had at least one or two updates already, so we'll probably get that fixed sooner or later. We're just going straight through here. We're gonna get down to the border today. See exactly where we're at here. As I veer all over the road. Yeah, we're getting kind of close. Down in here around San Diego. Yeah. We should at least be able to get into Mexico today. For sure, for sure. This looks a little bit more like the stock SES part of it here. Oh, hell, right here's the border. Oh, sweet mother Shinto! Whoopsie! That might draw some attention. That might draw some attention. If this were real, that we might get flagged for inspection, I'm just gonna say. Mexico. We have arrived. Yeah, I was not even paying attention to the speeds there, not gonna lie. Just kind of looking at the map and just not paying attention at all. Hopefully the speed limit kind of picks up here just a little bit. Maybe just a little bit. I'm just kind of checking everything out, trying to see what's up ahead here. Coming up on Tijuana. Traffic is just a little bit congested here to start. Not sure what the deal is with the 20 mile an hour speed limit, but we could be at this light for a little while. Not gonna lie, I think we could be here for a few minutes. Oh, AI, what are you doing? This is kind of like real life. I mean, hey, there's an open lane of traffic. Let's go over here. Forget the fact that it merges into one lane. Yeah, this is kind of a hot mess right here. There we go, the speed limit picked up. And I did read something about the speed bumps, and it does seem like so far there's quite a few of them. Just have to keep an eye on that. going forward, I guess. More red trailers. Zioshan. Now that is pretty cool. Gotta say, so far I'm liking what Viva Mexico has to offer. See how close we are. Too far out. Should be able to take off in a second. I think it's got enough horsepower. Just looking at the map, it looks like this is actually a pretty big add-on, so it'll be kind of fun to explore this a little bit. Kind of curious what kind of elevations and stuff like that there are too. Seems like we're on a little bit of an incline here, so. And more speed bumps. I don't know, maybe that's a thing down in Mexico, I don't know. But it just seems kind of odd that there would be speed bumps out on the highway when the speed limit's like 55. Scenic shot here, for sure. The beach. Now you got some traffic running down there. That's pretty cool. So far, this ain't too bad at all. Yeah, I think this map's gonna be a lot of fun for sure. was close. Check again here. Yeah, we're just about there. So yeah, get this delivered today. Right on. I don't imagine there's truck truck dealers down here too. So maybe I can get a save going on down to Mexico. Well, you gotta just drive around Mexico, swap out some trucks and stuff like I do in the stock map. I gotta say, the only knock so far is all these speed bumps. Ah, sweet, there is a Kenworth dealer. Awesome, awesome. I don't know, one truck I'd really, really like to see modded in ATS would be like a International Transtar 2. That would be freaking amazing. That is one of my all-time favorite trucks right there. Try to skip a few gears there. That didn't work out so well. Nice. Kenworth truck dealer discovered. Hello. Ah, there's a garage over there too. That's awesome. This crazy thing out. That should not be too hard. Looks like they have some decent loads coming out of here. There, that should not be too bad at all. Pull up here, get straightened out, and should just go with the stream here. little bit straighter. I'm gonna kill the truck too. Go, guys. Well, that's going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories in the Road. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. If you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. And be sure to check out the description section for my Twitch TV stream for links to all the mods used today. But guys, I'm going to cut on out of here for now. Until the next episode, stay safe out there. Take care, and we'll be seeing you.